When it comes to cholesterol, it's possibly one of the most misunderstood topics in health today. You may be watching, thinking, I've got nothing to worry about. My cholesterol is in a healthy range. Or perhaps you are concerned because you've been told your levels are too high. Either way, some experts are claiming that the conventional methods of cholesterol testing are flawed. They believe high cholesterol is not always a bad thing, and that low levels of cholesterol can be hazardous. Their belief is that it's not the cholesterol level that matters, but rather the size of the cholesterol, which we'll explain in a moment, while also revealing the top 10 vegetables that can help fight unhealthy cholesterol. Before you get this inside scoop, make sure to like this video and subscribe to Heart Disease Code. We've got amazing new content each week. Also, stick around because later in this video, we'll show you how to receive 2 free gifts on us. If you've been told your cholesterol is high, you may have been put on medication and advised to go on a low-fat diet. However, some experts argue that high cholesterol doesn't always mean a higher risk of heart disease. Did you know that approximately 50% of people who have heart attacks don't have high cholesterol? The Lyon Diet Heart Study looked at 605 high-risk patients and split them into 2 groups. The first group ate a Mediterranean-type diet with emphasis on fresh fruit and vegetables, whole grains, legumes, nuts, and healthy fats such as olive oil and seafood. The second group followed the advice of their physicians to follow a prudent diet of low fat and no more than 300 milligrams of cholesterol a day, the equivalent of 2 eggs. The astounding thing about this study is that it was stopped. Why? The reason was the reduction of heart attacks in the higher fat diet group was so much lower that it was considered unethical to continue. But what's fascinating is the cholesterol levels in the Mediterranean group didn't budge. Wait a minute, did you get that? The reduction of heart attacks had dropped so dramatically they could no longer continue the study, but their cholesterol levels stayed the same. Interesting, huh? So this brings us back to the idea that lower cholesterol isn't always the answer to preventing heart attacks. Some heart disease experts now believe the size and health of the cholesterol in your blood is more important than just the overall amount of it. Basically put, if your cholesterol is large and fluffy-like, opposed to small and dense, and it also hasn't been damaged by toxins or other nasties in the bloodstream, they claim this is what you really want, which is achieved through, you guessed it, a healthy diet. That's why we're going to explain to you the top 10 vegetables that can help get your cholesterol healthy. Without further ado, let's get started. Number 10, green beans. Green beans may be a staple in many kitchens, but ensuring you eat them regularly could be beneficial for healthy cholesterol levels. They're a great source of vitamin K, C, and A. They provide protein and iron, so if you're a vegetarian, you'll want to include these in your meals. Eating them fresh is better over canned, as canned beans can contain added sodium, which is known to be bad for heart disease. The things to remember about green beans is they're rich in soluble fiber. Soluble fiber may help lower LDL cholesterol, or the so-called bad cholesterol, as well as total cholesterol levels. Beans are so easy to add into your diet too. They can be added to stir fries, salads, or just saute them with some extra virgin olive oil and garlic. Number 9, avocado. Okay, I know some people may say this is a fruit, not a vegetable, but considering it's savory, we added it to the list. Avocados contain mono-unsaturated fats and fiber, both of which are great for lowering unhealthy levels of cholesterol. When you eat monounsaturated fats in their natural form, they may aid in protecting your cells by keeping them functioning well. Some experts now believe this is crucial to avoiding cardiovascular disease. Avocados can be added to smoothies, salads, spread onto toast, or made into a delicious dip. So what have you got to lose? Next time you go to the store, make sure to add this to your grocery list. Now for our next vegetable, you may think this is actually a spice, but in fact it is a vegetable. Number 8. Ginger. Ginger has been used for centuries in cooking and therapeutics. Due to its rich antioxidants, it's often used to help reduce the severity of inflammatory conditions such as arthritis. In a 2008 study, ginger was found to help increase HDL cholesterol, or the good cholesterol, and lower LDL cholesterol, the bad cholesterol. Furthermore, a 2014 study demonstrated that ginger helps to lower total cholesterol and triglycerides. So to get the benefits of this healthy food, you can grate it into curries, make teas with it, and even add small amounts to smoothies. Our next vegetable was made famous by Popeye the Sailor Man. Can you guess what it is? Number 7, spinach. Spinach is known to be rich in protein. However, it's not just a rich source of protein, but also of fiber. 1 cup providing a whopping 6 grams. Fiber is believed to play an important role in lowering cholesterol. Spinach also acts as a bile acid sequestrant. In simple terms, this means it aids in binding up bile acids. Bile acids are made by the liver from cholesterol. If they are bound up, cholesterol is then used to make more. This reduces the amount of cholesterol in the blood. To reap the benefits of this vegetable, why not just add 1/2 cup to a delicious smoothie or use baby spinach in your salads? Number 6, onion. Although onions may make your breath smell a little less than fresh, it could be a vital food to eat for healthy levels of cholesterol. A 2017 study has found that a compound found in onions called quercetin helps lower cholesterol in rodents fed a high-fat diet. It may lower cholesterol by decreasing your body's uptake of it and improving the conversion of cholesterol to bile acids. Furthermore, it can help prevent inflammation and hardening of the arteries. This may be beneficial to people with unhealthy cholesterol. Onions are easy to add into a lot of dishes. However, be sure to cook them up first. It appears that heat-treated onions are more effective at lowering cholesterol compared to raw ones. We're about to unveil our number 5 to number 1 vegetable for lowering cholesterol, along with a unique Korean dish that is believed to have special cholesterol-lowering qualities. But right now, it's time to show you how to grab our 2 amazing free gifts. If you can't get enough of learning how to lower your cholesterol and get heart healthy, then be sure to grab our free ebook, The Truth About Fat and Cholesterol. And if you'd really like to understand the full picture of fighting and preventing heart disease, check out episode 1 of the Untold Story of Heart Disease documentary series. Both gifts are free and waiting for you now. Just click the link below in the description. Number 5, cauliflower. Did you know cauliflower was once thought to be a poor man's broccoli? But now it's back with a vengeance, with people using it as a substitute for pizza bases, breads, and rice. For our vegan friends, it makes a great meat substitute, with dishes such as buffalo wings and cauliflower tacos being top of the menu. So with all its uses, you'll be glad to know that it also contains antioxidants, magnesium, vitamin C, omega-3, and the inflammation-fighting vitamin K. Cauliflower is an excellent source of dietary fiber, which we've already learned is great for keeping cholesterol healthy. Furthermore, it's rich in plant sterols, the fat that helps block cholesterol from absorbing in the intestines. To get the benefits of this nutrient-dense vegetable, be sure to make use of all the different substitutes you can use it for. Our next vegetable is one that you may not have heard of, but it's gaining popularity, and so it should. Not only is it packed with nutrients, but also contains a special compound that helps bind up cholesterol. Number 4, okra. Okra, also known as lady fingers, is an unusual flowering plant with edible seeds. It contains vitamin A and C, has high levels of fiber, and is a great source of magnesium, all of which are associated with a healthy heart. Yet it's thought that the polyphenols found in this vegetable are what gives it the ability to aid in reducing the risk of heart disease. Furthermore, In a 2017 study, it was found to lower cholesterol in mice. This is believed to be due to the special substance I mentioned, a thick gel-like substance called mucilage, which can bind to cholesterol during digestion, resulting in it being excreted in stools rather than absorbed into your body. Add this unusual vegetable to your curries, stir-fry dishes, and help get your cholesterol healthy. Number 3, eggplant. Eggplant, otherwise known as aubergine, is a nutrient-dense vegetable. It contains vitamin K and C, along with the minerals manganese and potassium. Its rich purple color is believed to be because of the chemical it has that protects cells from damage. This is essential when it comes to healthy cholesterol. A 2014 study conducted on rodents found that an antioxidant called chlorogenic acid, which is abundant in aubergine, can reduce levels of LDL cholesterol. It can be used in a variety of dishes, from moussaka to salads, and even as an alternative to pizza base. Number 2, cabbage. Cabbage has a wide array of nutrients such as vitamin K, C, folate, magnesium, and potassium. It's also a good source of fiber and powerful antioxidants, including polyphenols and sulfur compounds. Cabbage contains plant sterols. As we've already mentioned, these are the fats that help block cholesterol from absorbing in the intestines. Furthermore, cabbage is used to make the Korean dish kimchi, that is made with salt and left to ferment along with onions, garlic, ginger, etc. Kimchi appears to have a particular strain of helpful bacteria called lactobacilli. A study published in the International Journal of Food Microbiology found that the specific strain found in kimchi lowered total serum cholesterol. So whether you make a cold slaw, add it to your soups, or ferment it, cabbage is a must for anyone wanting to get healthy cholesterol. We're about to unveil our number one vegetable for lowering cholesterol. Just don't forget to like this video and subscribe to Heart Disease Code. Also, be sure to grab both of your two free gifts, The Truth About Fat and Cholesterol and Episode 1 of the Untold Story of Heart Disease documentary series, by clicking the link below in the description. And now, the number one vegetable for lowering cholesterol is kale. Unless you've been living under a rock for the last 5 years, you've no doubt heard about the health benefits of kale. This green, leafy vegetable is touted as a superfood, as it's one of the most nutrient-dense food known to man. Not only does it contain a whole host of nutrients such as vitamin K and C, but it's low in calories, so consuming it can help with weight management. This vegetable is packed with antioxidants, which are beneficial for repairing oxidative damage. Antioxidants are especially vital for keeping your cholesterol healthy and preventing heart disease. When it comes to cholesterol, not only does it pack a punch with antioxidants, but also acts as a bile acid sequestrant. As we've already explained, it means it aids in binding up bile acids, reabsorbing them, and in turn reducing the amount of cholesterol in the blood. A 2008 study found that participants who drank kale juice every day for 12 weeks increased HDL, the good cholesterol, by 27% and lowered LDL, the bad cholesterol, by 10%. So whether you juice it, steam it, or turn it into kale chips, be sure to add this vegetable to your diet. So there you have our top 10 vegetables to help lower cholesterol and keep it healthy. What vegetables are you going to increase in your diet to prevent heart disease? Let us know in the comments section below. And make sure to stay tuned to Heart Disease Code to discover more wonderful nutrition and wellness insights. And once again, don't leave without grabbing both of your two free gifts. Just click the link below. Thanks for watching and have a heart healthy day.